नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 17. इफ द प्लेट्स ऑफ द पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर आर नॉट इक्वल इन एरिया देन द क्वांटिटी ऑफ द चार्ज ए ऑन द प्लेट्स विल बी सेम बट नेचर ऑफ द चार्ज विल डिफर ऑन द प्लेट्स एज वेल एज नेचर ऑफ द चार्ज विल बी डिफरेंट ऑन द प्लेट्स विल बी डिफरेंट बट नेचर ऑफ द चार्ज विल बी सेम एज वेल एज नेचर ऑफ द चार्ज विल बी सेम. तो चार्ज की पोलैरिटी आणि मैग्नीट्यूड बद्दल आपल्याला क्वेश्चन विचारलेला आहे. सो सपोज दीज आर द टू प्लेट्स, प्लेट्स पी वन एंड प्लेट पी टू, दे आर हैविंग इक्वल एरिया. दिस एरिया इज ए वन, दिस एरिया इज ए टू. सो इफ प्लस क्यू चार्ज इज गिवन हियर देन इट इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड यूनिफॉर्मली लाइक दिस. So here minus Q charge is induced here. So signs are opposite, but magnitude is same. So when A1 is not equal to A2, then charge magnitude of the charge on both plates P1 and P2 is the same but of opposite in nature or sign. One is positive, other is negative. So the charges have different nature, but magnitude of the charge is same, and therefore the correct choice is A. A is correct. A is correct. इथे आपल्याला अजून एक इफेक्ट माहिती पाहिजे. सी, इक्वल अमाउंट ऑफ चार्ज इज प्रेझेंट इन अ स्मॉल एरिया, देअरफॉर सरफेस चार्ज डेन्सिटी विल बी मोर इन दिस केस अँड देअरफॉर इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड बिकम्स नॉन युनिफॉर्म. सो दिस इज सिग्मा वन. म्हणजे इथे आपला प्रश्न झपलेला आहे. अजून आपण एक पॉईंट ऍड करतो. सिग्मा वन इज इक्वल टू क्यू अपॉन A1 सरफेस चार्ज डेन्सिटी म्हणजे काय असा पण क्वेश्चन विचारला जातो. सरफेस चार्ज डेन्सिटी ऑफ द प्लेट P1 सिग्मा 2 इज इक्वल टू मायनस क्यू अपॉन दिस इज A1 दिस इज A2 सरफेस चार्ज डेन्सिटी ऑफ द प्लेट P2 सिन्स A1 इज ग्रेटर दॅन A2 देअरफॉर सिग्मा 1 इज लेस देन सिग्मा 2 देअरफॉर द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ई इज नॉन युनिफॉर्म स्ट्रॉंगर वीकर नियर P1 and stronger near P2. So on this side E is stronger E is weaker E is weaker. The electric field मध्ये पण चेंज होतो. इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड विल नॉट रिमेन युनिफॉर्म. इफ एरियाज आर इक्वल देन डेफिनेटली फील्ड विल बी युनिफॉर्म. म्हणजे काय असं पण क्वेश्चन भेटला होतो. electric field is uniform, electric field is non-uniform, so electric field becomes non-uniform, like this.
कपॅसिटी पण चेंज होते. असे बरेच क्वेश्चन्स आपल्याला बघायला मिळतील.
नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 18. इट इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टंट क्वेश्चन. वॉट चेंजेस टेक प्लेस ड्यू टू द एडिशन ऑफ द मीडियम दॅट प्रोड्यूसेस. सो आय विल रीड द क्वेश्चन. C, V, U and Q are capacitance, potential difference, energy stored and charge of a parallel plate capacitor respectively. The quantities that increase when a dielectric slab is introduced between the plates without connecting the battery are. The battery आपण disconnect केलेली नाही आहे.
When?
बॅटरी रिमेन्स कनेक्टेड देन विथ मीडियम विदाउट मीडियम. Without medium is there is a air medium. So which medium of dielectric conductivity different quantities are like this. Capacity Cm is equal to K times C0. So capacity increases. C increases result. Then charge qm is equal to k times q0. Without medium charge is q0, so charge q also increases. Medium add keltar dielectric medium cha constant pramane charge vadelo. Potential difference vm is equal to v0. No change. Then electric field EM is equal to E0, no change. And potential energy stored. U medium is equal to K times U0, so U increases. So these are the results. U is equal to 1/2 CV square. So UM is equal to 1/2 K times KMVM square. U0 is equal to 1/2 K0 V0 square. So if you divide this U medium upon U air is equal to 1 upon of cancel. So K medium upon K0 Vm upon V0 bracket square. These two are equal, so this is equal to K. So energy stored with medium is equal to P times energy stored with air. The relation upon this is proved. So see the result. Capacity increases, charge increases, potential energy stored increases. So due to addition, of dielectric slab, capacity C charge Q and energy stored U increases. तर तीन क्वांटिटी इन्क्रीज होतात आहे. आता आपल्याला चॉईसमध्ये दोनच क्वांटिटी दिलेल्या आहेत फक्त. हो सर, तर त्याप्रमाणे कुठला प्रश्न असेल मग ए चॉईस व्ही अँड सी पोटेन्शियल डिफरन्स सेम म्हणजे ए कट झाला. बी व्ही अँड यू पोटेन्शियल सेम राहतो म्हणजे बी कट झाला. म्हणजे व्हीमुळे ए बी डी कट झाले, आता राहिले फक्त सी आणि ई. तर सीमध्ये यू आणि क्यू दिलेलं आहे आणि सीमध्ये फक्त यू घेतलेला, क्यू घेतलेला नाही. क्यू पण इन्क्रीज होतो म्हणजे करेक्ट सी आला होतो. Therefore, C is correct. Only C is correct. Potential में तीन choice कट दले, राइल ले दोन पे की. Correct choice अपने ला C मिला ला. So, these results are correct under this condition only, when the battery remains connected. मग आपण चार्ज केला जेव्हा, जर बॅटरी आपण डिस्कनेक्ट केली असते तर चार्ज बदलणार नाही तेव्हा. म्हणजे इथे नो चेंज आला असतो कपॅसिटी बोलून, नो चेंज इन चार्ज, पोटेन्शियल वगैरे एनर्जी चेंज झाली असते फक्त तेव्हा. म्हणजे सी आणि यू जेव्हा चेंज झाला असतो. हे तसा पण क्वेश्चन असणार आहे, न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लेम पण त्या टाईपचे आहेत. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 19. इन अ कॅपॅसिटर ऑफ कॅपॅसिटन्स 20 मायक्रो फॅरेड, द डिस्टन्स बिटवीन द प्लेट्स इज 2 मिलीमीटर. इफ अ डायलेक्ट्रिक स्लॅब ऑफ विड्थ 1 मिलीमीटर अँड डायलेक्ट्रिक कॉन्स्टंट 2 is connected between the plates, the new capacitance will be. So definitely capacity increases, so it will be more than 20, and therefore we have to find answer. Only D will cut like this. So we already know this formula. फिगर कटण्याची गरज नाही, पण फिगर प्रॉब्लेम लवकर लक्षात येईल. सो सपोज दीज आर द टू प्लेट्स सेपरेटेड बाय डिस्टन्स डी. नाउ दिस इज द डायलेक्ट्रिक स्लॅब व्हिच थिकनेस इज टी. सो दिस थिकनेस इज डी मायनस टी लाईक दिस. सो दिस इज के वन इज इक्वल टू 1, which is K2 is equal to 2, and we have to find C dash. So C dash is equal to capacity of partially filled by dielectric capacity of a condenser. So C dash is equal to C into A epsilon naught upon D1 upon K1 plus D2 upon K2. So A epsilon naught, this is D1 is equal to D minus T upon 1. This is only T upon 2. But T is equal to D by 2. So C dash is equal to A epsilon naught upon D minus D by 2 plus D upon 2 multiplied by 2 D upon 2 multiplied by 2. So A epsilon naught, this is D by 2 plus this is D by 4. So this is equal to A epsilon naught 3D by 4. So 4 by 3 multiplied by A epsilon naught upon D. So C dash is equal to 4 by 3 multiplied by C.
4 by 3 multiplied by C.
So now substitute. New capacity C dash is equal to 4 by 3 multiplied by 20. So that is equal to 80 by 3. So it is equal to 26.67 microfarad. So capacity increases and it becomes this much. So correct answer is B. And therefore, B is
correct.
Next, एक अच्छे अच्छे जो तीन चार प्रॉब्लम लिए हैं फॉर्मूले और से. When a sheet of aluminium foil of negligible thickness is introduced between the plates of the capacitor, the capacitance of the capacitor decreases, remains unchanged, becomes infinite and increases. So here the correct choice is B. Why? So again you can use this formula. C dash is equal to C A epsilon naught D minus T plus T by K. Since thickness T is a negligible, therefore T is equal to 0, therefore C dash is equal to A epsilon naught upon D, that is equal to C. So C dash is equal to C. Therefore, capacity remains unchanged. Capacity remains unchanged under this condition. हाँ तिकडे जर निग्लेजिबल नसेल तर मात्र मग आपल्याला व्हॅल्यू कॅल्क्युलेट करावी लागेल. अँड देअरफोर द करेक्ट चॉईस इज बी. बी इज करेक्ट. बी इज करेक्ट. Next, 21. What is the potential difference across the 2 microfarad capacitor in the circuit shown? 12, 4, 6, 18. 18 the circuit nahi. And circuit madhe maximum EMF 16 volt dileli. So given circuit is like this. Figure E. So this is E1 is equal to 16 volt. This is E2 is equal to 6 volt. C1 is equal to 2 microfarad. C2 is equal to 3 microfarad. And we have to find potential difference across C1. So V1 is equal to question mark. Since like polarities of E1 and E2 are connected in are connected together therefore net EMF E in the circuit is E is equal to higher minus lower E1 minus E2 16 minus 6 that is equal to 10 volt. Therefore, the circuit of figure E can be drawn as this is C1. This is C2 and this is E is equal to 10 volt like this. Therefore, now this is V1 is equal to question mark. Now C1 and C2 are in series. Therefore, 1 upon Cs effective capacity is equal to 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2, 1 upon 2 microfarad plus 1 upon 3 microfarad that is equal to 5 by 6. And therefore, Cs is equal to 6 by 5 microfarad. This is the equation. Let Q be the charge supply. That Q is equal to charge supply to series combination. There is combination of C1 and C2. Therefore, Q is equal to Cs into V is equal to, this is 6 by 5 into 10 to minus 6 multiplied by 10. That is equal to 12 into 10 to minus 6 coulomb. Q is equal to 12 into 10 raised to minus 6 coulomb. This is equation second. Now, C1 is equal to Q upon V1. Therefore, V1 is equal to potential difference across C1 is equal to 2 microfarad. And therefore, V1 is equal to Q upon C1. So, 12 into 10 raised to minus 6 using this value, and C1 is equal to 2. And therefore, V2 into 10 raised to minus 6. So, this is equal to 6 volt. V1 is equal to 6 volt. So, potential difference across the 2 microfarad capacitor is equal to 6 volt. म्हणजे इकडे 6 व्होल्ट असेल आणि इकडे 4 व्होल्ट असेल. म्हणजे आपल्याला इथे प्रॉब्लेम आपला संपला. देअरफॉर द करेक्ट चॉईस इज सी. सी इज करेक्ट. नाउ यू कॅन ऍड दिस पॉईंट. व्ही इज इक्वल टू व्ही वन प्लस व्ही टू. देअरफॉर व्ही टू इज इक्वल टू व्ही मायनस व्ही वन इज इक्वल टू 10 व्होल्ट minus 6 volt, that is equal to 4 volt. So V2 is equal to potential difference across C2 is equal to 3 microfarad. The V2 which I was open up to look at the usual time. So remember the procedure. Now these two sources of electricity cell are connected like this. Positive of E1 is connected to positive of E2, and therefore they are in opposition. Therefore the net EMF will be equal to E1 minus E2. याच्या पोलॅरिटी जर आपण उलट्या केल्या, निगेटिव्ह इकडे घेतला, पॉझिटिव्ह इकडे घेतला, तर ते सिरीजमध्ये येतील ते. आणि सिरीजमध्ये आले असते तर टोटल EMF आपल्याला 16+6 इज इक्वल टू 12 व्होल्ट घ्यावी लागली असती. हे बॅटरीच्या पोलॅरिटी महत्त्वाची आहे. सो द नेट EMF E इज इक्वल टू E1 मायनस E2 फॉर दिस टाईप ऑफ पोलॅरिटी अँड E1 प्लस E2 फॉर ऑपोजिट पोलॅरिटी ऑफ E2 लाईक दिस. सो दिस इज द नेट EMF. सो द सर्किट ऑफ फिगर A कॅन बी गिव्हन लाईक दिस. सो देर इज अ नेट EMF ऑफ 10 व्होल्ट अँड दीज टू कंडेन्सर C1 C2 आर इन सिरीज. सो देअर इफेक्टिव्ह कपॅसिटी इज गिव्हन बाय दिस युज्युअल फॉर्म्युला. इट इज 6/5 microfarad. सो to this series combination the charge supplied is Q. It is calculated by Q is equal to Cs into V. We know already Cs, V is equal to 10 volt. So this is the total charge supplied by the battery, and therefore potential difference across the first condenser is given by V1 is equal to Q upon C1. Total charge supplied is this 12 into 10 raised to minus 6. C1 is equal to 2 microfarad. So 2 into 10 raised to minus 6, and therefore answer is 6 volt. So out of 10 volt, 6 volt is here, and therefore 4 volt will be here. So total voltage applied is 10 volt. Potential difference across C1 is equal to 6 volt. Potential difference across C2 is equal to 4 volt. So potentially divided in series combination, charge remains same. This property can be verified by such problems like this. An electron enters the space between the plates of a charged capacitor as shown. Actually, figure is not given. The charge density of the plate is sigma. The electric field intensity in the space between the plates is E. A uniform magnetic field B also exists in the space perpendicular to the direction of E. The electron moves perpendicular to both E and B without any change in direction. This condition is important. Underline this: without any change in direction. The time taken by the electron to travel a distance L in the space is तर इथे आपल्याला काही इक्वेशन माहिती करून घ्यावं लागतं. 11th ला कुठेतरी तो झालेली आपल्याला. सो दीज आर द टू प्लेट्स ऑफ ए पॅरलल प्लेट कंडेन्सर. Suppose this is having positive charge. Surface charge density sigma. This is having negative charge. So electric field is directed in this away from positive toward the negative. So this is plate P1, this is plate P2. Our Cartesian coordinate system is like this. This is x axis, this is y axis, and this is z axis. So E is equal to electric field between the two plates P1 and P2 directed along minus y axis. E is equal to sigma upon epsilon naught E question 1. So this is the magnitude, this is the direction. Fe is equal to electric force acting on electron of charge minus E. Therefore, Fe is equal to minus E into E. Fe is equal to E into E in magnitude. In magnitude, and Fe is along positive axis. Electric field is along negative axis, minus sign shows that this will be along the positive axis. So if this is a electron minus E, so this is the force acting Fe. Now the magnetic field is applied in the negative z direction. Let B is equal to magnetic field acting or present between P1 and P2, between P1 and P2 along negative z axis. This is negative z axis, shown by circle and cross, shown by circle and cross. So remember this equation. Now the positive charge is given to the upper plate P1. By induction, equal and opposite charges are produced. Therefore, electric field is always directed from positive to negative. So electric field is directed along the negative y-axis. In this electric field, when the charge minus E of the electron moves with velocity V in x direction, velocity is in the positive direction. This is the Cartesian coordinate system of our figure. X axis, y axis, and z axis. Z axis is perpendicular to the plane of the figure. Now, this electron will experience the electric force Fe in the electric field E, and it is given by Fe is equal to electrostatic formula minus E into E. So, Fe is equal to E into E in magnitude. Now, minus sign shows that electric field is along the negative y axis, therefore, this electric force is along the positive axis. So, the arrow is shown by the blue color. So Fe is directed along the positive y. Now this is the one force acting on the electron due to the electric field. Now in the space between the two plates, there is one more field, magnetic field applied. It is perpendicular to the electric field. So we have shown that electric field is directed into the plane of the paper shown by cross. So it is in the negative z direction. So B is a magnetic field present between the plates P1 and P2 along the negative z axis.
so shown by this cross, circle and cross. So this magnetic field exerts the force FB and it is given by this formula. आपण 11th ला मॅग्नेटिक इफेक्ट्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट मध्ये हा फॉर्म्युला ऑलरेडी यूज केलेला आहे लॉरेन्स फोर्सच्या इक्वेशनच्या अगोदर. सो FB इज इक्वल टू चार्ज ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन मायनस ई इंटू बी क्रॉस बी. देअरफॉर यूजिंग दिस इक्वेशन वी कॅन डिटर्मिन द मॅग्नेट्यूड अँड डायरेक्शन. नाऊ सी इन दिस फिगर V इज अलॉंग द पॉझिटिव्ह ॲक्सिस अँड B इज इन द निगेटिव्ह झेड ॲक्सिस. सो अँगल बिटवीन देम इज 90 degrees. सो बाय rule of vector product V cross B is equal to VB sin theta, but theta is equal to 90 degrees. So the magnitude is given by E V B sin theta. Magnitude is minus sin jigger. So sin 90 is equal to 1, therefore this is equal to E V B equation 3. This is the magnitude. The magnetic force experienced by the electron has magnitude this much. Now direction. Now by the right hand rule, V cross B vector product of velocity vector V and B. It is in the positive y direction, therefore because of minus sign FB will be in the positive y negative y axis. So the electron experiences the two forces, one is FE in the upward direction, second one is FB in the downward direction because of magnetic field. Now electric field becomes strong, electron will be deflected above x axis. If magnetic field becomes strong, the electron moves below the x-axis like this. But if these two forces, electric field and magnetic field forces, they become equal in magnitude and opposite direction, they are already in opposite direction in our figure. If they are equal in magnitude and opposite direction, they cancel each other. And if they cancel each other, then there will be no change in magnitude and direction because there is no net force. So electron will continue. Electron will continue its motion along the positive x-axis without any change in direction, undeviated, without any change in magnitude. No change in magnitude, no change in direction when the net force acting on the electron is zero. And therefore, this is the condition. When the electron moves undeviated, then FB and FE are equal in magnitude. By substituting 2 and 3, we get velocity of the electron is equal to E by B, where E is the electric field intensity between the two plates, B is the magnetic field intensity between the two plates. Same formula we have used for the electromagnetic waves. If E is the electric field, B is the magnetic field in the electromagnetic waves, then velocity of the electromagnetic wave is given by this much and it comes to be 3×10⁸ meter per second in free space. So velocity is equal to distance upon time, so L by T. So when the electron moves through distance L, then the time taken T is calculated by using this formula. Time taken T is equal to arranging this formula L upon V, distance covered upon velocity. Velocity is substituted from equation A. So this is equal to L into B by E. And E is the electrical intensity between the two plates. It is already given by sigma upon epsilon naught, where sigma is a surface charge density. So the final equation is T is equal to epsilon naught L into B upon sigma. तर इक्वेशनमधले क्वेश्चनमधले चॉईस बघितल्यानंतर आपल्याला आयडिया देत नाही की नेमके कसा अप्रोच व्हायचं आहे. तर टाईम काढायचा म्हणजे आपल्याला डिस्टन्स अपॉन वेलॉसिटीचा फॉर्म्युला यूज करावा लागेल आणि वेलॉसिटी हा फॉर्म्युला आहे. तर हा फॉर्म्युला तुम्ही डायरेक्ट यूज करू शकता. याचा आपल्याला अजून ही थिअरी माहिती नाही म्हणून आपण इथे यूज केलेली. सो यू कॅन डायरेक्टली स्टार्ट फ्रॉम इक्वेशन ए लाईक दिस. सो दिस इज अबाउट द टाईम टेकन बाय द इलेक्ट्रॉन इन द क्रॉस फील्ड. When the electric field and magnetic field are perpendicular to each other, they are in the cross direction, then this condition is important. The electron moves undeviated when the velocity is equal to E by B like this. So this type of equations can be used separately for electron motion in uniform electric field, equation 2. Then separately it is moving in magnetic field B perpendicular to. Actually this equation is important. FB is perpendicular to the plane of B and B, and therefore this charge particle will perform the circular motion, and that radius of the circular motion can also be obtained by using the same equation. The cyclotron ची theory जी थी या equation वर base असते थी. तो ये high point आपल्याला माहिती पाहिजे. Now FB is perpendicular, see this figure. FB is perpendicular to B and plane of B and B, and therefore this FB is perpendicular to B, it will perform the circular motion. ही circular motion ची necessary condition आहे. आपण इथे अजून एक point आपण add करू शकतो. We know the property of the circular motion. So
since FB is perpendicular to velocity V, therefore charged particle may be proton, may be charged particle performs uniform circular motion having radius r, because FB provides centripetal force necessary for circular motion. Therefore, FB is equal to CPF. So, E into B is equal to mv square upon R, formula for centripetal force. Therefore, R is equal to mv upon B. So, this is the radius of the circular path. Radius R is given by m, mass of the charge particle, velocity of the charge particle, velocity is given by this value, and Q, charge B, magnetic field. M is equal to mass of the charge particle. Like this. These equations are necessary for electron motion or proton motion in electric and magnetic field. Okay, so this is the additional point. We will require this formula: radius r of the circular path performed by the charged particle of charge q, mass m moving with velocity v in magnetic field b, and electric field e perpendicular to each other undeviated, like this. Okay, we will stop here. We will see remaining problem next time.